This is Press TV's Top 5. Thanks for joining us. The Secretary General of Lebanon's resistance movement Hezbollah says they are about to score a great military victory in the fight against Nusra Front terrorists on the Lebanon-Syria border.
I can say that we are in light of a great military achievement, which has been achieved only in 48 hours. The first 2 days were what made this transformation. Afterwards, we were the ones who were on purpose going slowly and bit by bit.
Sayyid Hassan Nasrallah said Hezbollah is winning a tough battle in our Sahel region despite numerous difficulties. Nasrallah hailed the Lebanese and Syrian army's assistance during operations against the terrorists. He said the terrorists were training suicide bombers in the border with Syria. Nasrallah noted that the Arsal operation that is taking place in a 100 square kilometer mountainous area was launched to remove the militants and armed groups from the region. To discuss that, we're now joined by Alexander Azadgan, who is a professor of international political economy, and he's joining us live now by Skype from California. Professor, how important do you think this fight against terrorists are on the Lebanon-Syria border?
Well, it's a great victory for Hezbollah. Hezbollah, as you're aware, is a tremendous force. It defeated Israel in the Israel-Lebanon war in 2006. The fact that these ISIS, Takfiri, Al-Nusra savages got so close to Lebanon, however, in the outskirts of the Lebanese town of Arsal, which is right in the border of Lebanon and Syria, does reveal to us how far Al-Nusra, who were formerly Al-Qaeda agents in Syria, got so close to Lebanon. You have to keep in mind that one of the major goals of the terrorists supporting a nation of Israel was to use these savages, be it Al-Nusra or even ISIS, to use them as a buffer between itself and versus Syria and Hezbollah. And in this victory, Hezbollah has proven that they are destroying that strategy of Israelis, which was a very reckless strategy that would come back and bite them. Although we all know that ISIS or Al-Nusra never made any attacks or threat of attacks to the Zionist entity. So I think we are the harbinger of a major defeat of these ISIS, Takfiri, Daesh savages, not just in other parts of Syria that we've been seeing, but in such a sensitive strategic location as Arsal.
Professor Azadgan, as you well know, there is a lot of criticism from many quarters about Hezbollah's involvement in Syria in the fight against terrorism, and if even within the country, in fact, in the fight against terrorists in Arsal. Do you think that all of those critics have been proven wrong?
Well, they are being proven wrong. Of course, this had been at the expense of a six-year war since 2011. Which has seen major parts of the Syrian infrastructure decimated. So clearly the Syrian, the legitimate Syrian army and their allies, the Russians, the Iranians, and Hezbollah, clearly they are winning, but the price has been very high. We have around 300 to 350,000 Syrian dead, 6 to 7 million Syrian refugees. However, it's a major strategic defeat for NATO and for Washington, which has, we know Washington has over 11 bases in southern Syria. It's a major defeat for their policy. Of course, if you delve into this further, Waqar, we know that even Washington and even NATO, they are sort of withdrawing their support from ISIS and al-Nusra, and they're putting it in SDF, Syrian so-called defense forces, which are a bunch of Salafis in addition to Kurds. Washington is putting all their marbles and all their betting on that card. So they're going to try to use the Kurd separatists in Syria and bring some of these people from Turkey and Iraq to continue giving the Syrian army trouble. But this defeat of the al-Nusra savages and Salafists is proving that if Hezbollah, which has lost many warriors, the estimates are between 2,000 to 5,000, that when they come into the battlefield, that there will be no holds barred and the terrorists will be defeated. And I think we should celebrate this victory.
Okay, Professor Azadgan, we'll leave there at that. But of course, as always, we appreciate your insight.